Hey guys, welcome to Firearm Empire. Today we're going to be discussing the Martian Commercial 6.35mm, which is also the same as 25 ACP. It was made by Martin Bascaran out of Eibar, Spain from about 1919 through 1928. It's pretty much a cheap knockoff of the 1906 Browning or Colt. So not a whole lot to it, pretty simple gun, pretty small. In today's value, it's worth only about $100 in working conditions, nothing too crazy. So let's get into kind of some disassembly and reassembly. There's not a whole lot out there on this gun, so I will walk you guys through it. So your first step, obviously, is safety check it and remove the magazine. Get that out of the way. It is empty. So your next step, the safety. You're going to slide it up, slide it back to that notch, and I'll click in. This isn't in there, the safety pin isn't in there very good, so you're going to want to hold it down, otherwise it can just pop back out, and flip the gun over. And then to disassemble, you're going to take the barrel and twist it to the right, and you'll see the locking grooves that come up, and it'll stop when it's done. And once you've twisted the barrel, bring it back over, release that safety, and it will come forward. It catches right here, so you usually have to push it a little bit harder, and it'll just come right out. You can remove the springs. And then as far as getting the barrel out, you're just going to twist it back, lift it up a little, and it'll just pop right out. And then for the firing pin, to get that guy out, you can usually just tip it a little bit, shake it. Firing pin will come right out. If you want to, you can remove all the pieces from that. It's just three little pieces, nothing too crazy. So move those back out here. Move that guy out of the way. If you want to remove the extractor, I'm not going to do it in this video. It's pretty simple though. Just remove this little top pin here, knock it out, and the extractor will just pop right out. But basically that's the breakdown of the top slide. And as far as the bottom area, the safety pin just pulls right out once you have the top slide removed. And then to get to the trigger and everything else, you're going to need to remove the left side grip. If you're looking at the gun as if you're holding it, left side grip, you'll need to remove that guy. You can remove both, there's really no point though. Set those guys offside. And that'll kind of expose all the inner workings. It's a very simple gun. So to remove the trigger, there's a little pin right here in between the fire and safe position that you're going to need to knock out. For that, you're going to use a 1/16 punch, and you're going to knock it from the left side down towards the right side. And the trigger's under a little pressure, so it should move back when you pull that out. It's not going to go anywhere though. Grab your pin. And now the trigger is free, so you're just going to need to lift it out a little bit. So pull up. And then it'll just come right out. And this guy, once you remove the trigger, he'll pull right out as well. And to get that out, we're going to need to depress this guy up here. For that, I use a 3/16 punch. And once you fully depress that, this will just pull right out. If you can't get it with your fingers, you can push it from the other side, but that does require taking off the other grip. So we'll do that just to show you. So this pin right here is the backside of this guy. So once you depress that, you can just push it through and then pull it out. This one's in there a little tighter than usual, so we're going to use another punch on the back just to get it out. There we go. And this guy has a spring, so release it slowly. Pull it out. And then to get that spring, it's pretty loose, so you can just shake a little bit, and that'll come right out. And now everything is fully disassembled. So now for reassembly, very simple, just do everything in reverse order basically. So we'll put the spring back in. Put this guy back in. And with it, you want the flat portion of the little notch to be facing the rear. And you're gonna put this guy in. Once you depress it, of course, you can kind of see what's doing in there. As we depress it, it kind of shows the notch, and that's what's holding it in. So line everything up, get your punch and depress it. And that guy will slide right back in. So now that's back in. You're going to take this, it's going to be like this, kind of like a little backwards J, I guess, as far as orientation. It'll just slide right in. You're going to push it all the way up to the top so you can get the trigger back in. And it's in there very loose, so you're going to need to hold the gun pretty level while you put the trigger in. The trigger can be a little tricky because it's spring-loaded, so it's going to want to fly backwards, but to get the pin in, you have to have it forward. So to keep it forward, I usually use that 3/16 punch again. And so that guy, just slide the spring back in, get everything lined up, and then you're going to need to use the punch to push the trigger forward until the hole lines up, and then you can just drop your pin in. Now that's in. If you need to get a little further, just give it a small tap with a hammer, push it all the way in. So now that we've done that, we can put the grips back on. We can see a little locking pin for the grips on the bottom there, which will line up with the hole drilled in the back. So you just put the pins together, line up your screws. Do the same on the other side. So now we got the grips back on. So our next step is to put everything back where it goes. So the firing pin, we're going to put the spring back in the end. The pin there. And then it just slides into the back. And then barrel back in, make sure the grooves are up when you put it in. And then we'll put the safety pin back in. put it in the down position to start. Take your recoil spring, slide it in the hole in the front there until it stops. And then we'll basically just be able to slide everything back on. Make sure your barrel's up. And once you get that initial slide where you had to push it off in the beginning, you're going to want to flip it over so you can see the location of the barrel, because you're going to need to play with the grooves a little bit to get everything back in there. So you're going to push it back to where the safety catches on the back. There we go. Make sure the locking bridges are up, and then push it back. Once it catches, just spin your barrel back down, release that safety thing on the back, and you are back together. Fire safe. Do a quick functions test. Everything's working. Put the magazine back in, and you're all set. That is the Martian Commercial 6.35 millimeter.